Brethren, the Bible says there was a man, a general in the Syrian army. He had everything going for him. Famous, powerful, wealthy, everything. But there was a comma in his life. He was a leper. He was a leper. Leprosy in those days was incurable. It was an irreversible situation. But guess what? Those of you who know the story. By the power of the Almighty God, God reversed that situation. The Bible says when he was cleansed of that leprosy, that his skin became like the skin of a baby. Brethren, when God restores, he does not restore the way man restores. When man restores, that you will still see that, well, he's not exactly perfect. Yeah, he's good, he's okay. But you still see some cracks here and there. But when God restores, it is always better than the original. An adult, his skin was restored, not to the skin of an adult, but to the skin of a baby. You serve a God who can reverse the irreversible. I don't know how many people are here who are subject to deportation. I don't know how many people are here who have one issue with the IRS that they say it is irreversible. I don't know which situation you have that they have told you it cannot be reversed, that it cannot be done. But I have come to tell you today, if you will believe this God with me today, he will reverse the irreversible for you. He will reverse the irreversible for you. Lift up your hands to heaven. Father, as many as are under the sound of my voice, who are in an irreversible situation that is giving them sorrow, that is giving them pain, that is bringing fear and agony into their spirit, you are a God who can reverse the irreversible. And we are trusting you today to do what only you can do. That situation that they have given up on, that situation that doctors have told them, oh, there is no solution here, it is irreversible. Father, let them testify to your power. Let these people come here and testify that you have reversed the irreversible. Now, open your mouth and say, Father, reverse the irreversible for me. Now, open your mouth and pray that prayer and begin to tell the Lord, you know the situation that is irreversible in your own matter. You know your own situation that it is irreversible. You have been told it is irreversible. There is nothing you can do about it. But you serve a God who can reverse the irreversible. Leprosy was incurable in those days. But God not only cured Naaman's leprosy, he restored his skin to that of a baby. To that of a baby. Because our God can do exceedingly, abundantly, above what we are asking or thinking. Call unto him today. Call unto God today. Father, you are the one who can reverse the irreversible. Reverse the irreversible for me. That's my situation that they say is irreversible. Father, reverse it for me today. I'm trusting you to reverse it for me today. Put testimony in my mouth. Put testimony in my mouth. Put testimony in the mouth of my family. Put testimony in the mouth of my pastors. Reverse the irreversible. Reverse the irreversible. Mention your case to him. Mention your case to the Lord. We are standing with you today in faith. We are agreeing with you today in faith. The church of God is standing with you. He can reverse the irreversible. Oh, we have to learn how to trust this God. We have to learn how to hold this God to his promise. He's a promise keeper. God is a promise keeper. The Bible says not a single one of his promises has failed. If God's promise has failed for you, it is not because God doesn't want to do it. It is not because he failed. It is you. He's not the problem. God is never the problem. His promises define their yes answer in Christ Jesus. The Bible says his promises are yes and amen in Christ Jesus. They find their yes answer in Christ Jesus. He can reverse the irreversible. Tell him, Father, reverse the irreversible in my case. Mention that case to the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.